KQBC, Seattle.
For an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised. Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
LoveLine, coast to coast.
Yep, it is LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew over there. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. I thought for a fleeting moment I'd give the fax number out, but...
I thought for a fleeting moment you were just going to fall asleep.
Yeah, close. Very close. Dr. Drew is a board-certified physician, an addiction medicine specialist, everybody. Cypress Hill, theoretically, is going to be in the hizzy. That's the house. You see?
Whose house?
His house. Mm. The hizzy house. The hizzy house tones. And they're not in our his house. They're in their his house.
Are they calling us from the...
Maybe they're driving from their his house? I don't know. The band smokes a lot of weed. You know, that changes. They may have forgotten to set their clocks forward.
Change your time perception a little bit.
It was only a couple of weeks ago. Anyway, we like Cypress Hill, so they should be in here for the... I don't know. How many times Cypress Hill been on this show? 5, 6 times?
No, this is...
Seems like a lot.
Wait, today's Monday, so 600 times.
600 yeah. times. So we'll look forward to seeing Cypress Hill when they come in. Until then... We'll hop on the phones and speak to Amy, who's 17. Amy?
Hi.
What's up, champ?
Nothing. I just have this problem. I've been recently going out with this guy for about 4 months now. And we've had sex before, but he, since then, one time, he asked me to give him oral sex. And ever since then, he, like, won't do anything else. And then he makes up these lies, and he'll be like, oh, well... Let's do oral sex first, so that way I'll last longer when we have sex. But
and then he never gets around to the sex.
Exactly.
Fascinating.
Interesting angle. How old is he?
He's 19.
Wow, he's really getting started early on this lying, deceitful oral sex angle I've made a life out of. Hmm. So you go down on him.
Mm-hmm.
He orgasms,
how
and then
done.
That's it for the night.
Yeah,
basically.
Why didn't you ever say, what about that second round?
I did, and he told me... He said tomorrow, and he says that, and then one time I got all angry, and he just drove off and left.
Uh-huh. He sounds like a delight, this gentleman.
Is this your boyfriend?
Kind of.
Yeah. Are you sure he thinks he's your boyfriend?
Yeah, he does, but I've been seeing other people, too.
Oh, good. Well, why don't you see more of the other people?
That's nice.
Yeah.
Are you screwing around with any of the other people?
No, no.
And how is it that you... I never could work this out. I know Drew has done this in his day because
why?
He's a passionate... Why? You're a passionate...
No, what have I done?
Passionate, passionate man. Well, you know when people go, yeah, I'm dating. I'm seeing some people.
Mm.
I've never been able to pull that one off. How does that work? You're having sex with one guy and you're dating a couple other guys? I think I may have been those other guys in women's lives who weren't getting laid.
That's how, yeah.
That's me.
Those are called friends.
Yeah, but they buy you stuff, and you, like, make out with them a little bit.
Dear friends.
Dear friends?
No, just dear friends.
Amy?
Yeah?
I don't like this guy. Why don't you break up with him?
That's what I was thinking about doing.
Good.
But it's just, like, that one time was pretty good.
The one time you had sex?
Uh-huh.
Does he go down on you?
Yeah.
Every time?
No, because we've only had sex about twice.
But how many times have you given him the BJ?
Several, over probably about 20.
Who? That's good of you. And when are you going to learn your lesson? I mean, you're up over 20 now.
I know.
Okay. This guy's flawed. If he, let me tell you something, ladies. Drew, tell me if you get behind this. Most men are pigs.
Yeah,
most of
I'm
them.
I'm behind that.
Eventually, they slide into a comfort zone. They do what they like to do. The flowers and the candy dry up. The mm-hmm. opening of doors slows down.
Mm-hmm.
The whatever movie you want to see, it's all the same to me.
Penny for your thoughts.
Yes. Oh, is it cuddle time yet, dear? Yeah. Hungarian food. I love Hungarian food. Now, all that dries up at a certain point. Usually, if the guy's a decent guy, maybe a year or two into the relationship, and it kind of evens out.
Yeah.
Then it's a little back and forth.
Yeah.
But if he's pulling this ass early in a relationship,
oh.
either he doesn't care about the relationship, or he's going to get worse.
Yeah. This is the best it's going to get.
Right. That's right.
And I would predict, you know, some guys can kind of get it together at different times in their life and suddenly become sort of good partners.
He's 19. This is 36, 37.
Yeah. I don't even think this guy has that in him. This kind of behavior is reprehensible. You know?
And here's another thing, ladies. Guys do pull it together at certain points in their life. Sometimes not within the relationship. This is five relationships from now. Do you know what I mean? He can get started down this path, and he can pull his ass together at some point.
Yes.
But it ain't with her.
Right. Not with this behavior.
No. Could have 3.5, 4 more girlfriends before he even begins to pull it together. Rita?
Yeah?
You're 16.
Hi.
What's up, champ?
Hi, I was listening to your show yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard you guys talking about, like, how this guy was raped by a guy.
Yeah. Rita?
Hello? Were we talking about how a guy was raped by a guy?
I remember last night or the night before, somebody had called and we were talking. He was asking whether a rape or childhood sexual abuse would make him gay. We had a discussion about whether that renders someone...
No, that was a girl's brother.
Yeah.
Right. But a guy didn't call in and say he was raped.
No.
Okay. Well, anyway, her line got cut off anyway. Jared?
Yes?
You're 20?
Hello.
Hello.
What's up?
I have a really bad problem with attachment disorder, I guess it is.
That's your diagnosis, or you actually have that?
I've been diagnosed at like 14 other times when I've tried to commit suicide.
Okay.
14 times you've tried to commit suicide?
15 times I did.
15?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's
different.
I went
to the doctor 14 times.
Okay. I see.
And
these are all in response to losses of some type or another?
Losses of, like, girlfriends and stuff, because, like, when I was really young, my mom got shot in the head, and I was, like, 5. It was a pretty bad loss. And then, like, in the last 2 years, like, 25 of my friends have died in different car accidents, literally.
Still, those tend to be more grief.
Hold on a second. Did he say 25?
That's what he said. Yeah.
Were they all in one bus as part of one traveling softball team, or did they die in separate cars?
They died in some of them died in the same car, some of them died in separate cars.
And this is within the last year?
2 years.
2 years. Hold on a second.
Yeah. 20, you don't have 25 friends.
Listen, I'm going to make any light of Jared's situation.
No.
But, this guy has a flair for what you call the dramatic.
Mm.
Suicide, 15 attempts, 25 friends have died in car crashes in the last 2 years?
I didn't have 25 friends in 20.
Listen, you haven't had 25 friends over your entire life.
Right.
Include your kids' friends and your wife's friends and your parents' friends. You haven't had 25 friends. You got me, buddy.
Thank you.
You understand?
And man, I don't even know you anymore.
And man, I'm this close to walking because it's like I don't even know you anymore. Jared?
Yes.
Really? I know why this show is horrible. I get stuck on something and I can't get past it. 25 friends.
Religiously. Yeah.
25 friends died in car crashes.
Yes.
All right. Wow. Anyone who's a friend of Jared who currently has a driver's license should steer clear. My God.
Now, true attachment disorders are from severe depravity in early childhood, like you're left in a crib for 2 years, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Well, like I was saying, like, if I get a girlfriend or something, I don't let it go and stuff. And then because all my girlfriends, basically, I'm not going to say all for sure, but basically all my girlfriends have cheated on me.
Yeah.
And then broke up with me for someone else and stuff like that.
Have there been 14 of those?
I don't know how many it was. A lot.
A lot of girlfriends.
Yeah.
Well, like, at least you can reel them in.
You know?
Yeah, that's worth something.
Sometimes, considering most of them are strippers anyways, and I'm tired of dating strippers.
Oh, right. That's interesting.
Yeah. I'd leave Jared, too, though, if I was dating him. I got to be honest.
Oh, thank you.
Jared.
Yeah, but he's dating strippers. They're not...
Yeah, that's not a relationship.
Yeah.
Jared, what are you doing for a living?
Right now, I'm managing a store in the city I live in.
I see. Not in a city in a country nearby.
No.
I see. And you doing any therapy?
None of it has ever worked. I mean, I was putting, like, hospitalization thing for like 2 months and it didn't work.
Mm-hmm.
And they've tried all kinds of different fun medicines that didn't work.
Right.
And
But Jared?
Yeah.
You're a 20-year-old guy. You got some energy. You're a little bit angry. You've had some bad things happen in your life. You're going to have to kind of let yourself go a little bit. I mean, you're going to have to throw yourself on the mercy of a therapist or a psychiatrist or a counseling group. You're going to have to give in. I mean, you can't keep that chip on your shoulder.
And it's not only that so much, but, like, I get to the point, like, right now, I'm to the point where I want to just not make an attempt to make it a permanent thing.
Suicide?
Yeah.
Well, how were you trying to kill yourself the other 15 times?
One of them was about 576 Vicodin.
And that wasn't the permanent attempt?
That didn't work because somebody had
got
me right after I'd got the...
You understand what Adam is saying? Is that what was your intention before if it wasn't...
It was.
How do you ingest 576 Vicodin? Wait a minute. How do you get hold of 576 Vicodin?
I was on Vicodin because I had broken my wrist and my ankle at the same time, and I just saved them up, and I never used them because I have a really high pain tolerance.
576 at once?
Yeah, downed them as many as I could, as fast as I could. And
but again,
people keep walking in on me when I do it, and they keep calling the hospital, and I keep getting rushed to the hospital all the time.
Hey,
yeah, but. Right. What weren't those you're saying as though you wanted to do something serious? Weren't those serious?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, he made a real attempt.
I've made valid attempts.
Okay.
But people keep walking me. I know.
Listen,
my ankles.
Jared, listen. You got bad luck when it comes to suicide. I know what you're saying.
Let me tell you.
You're cursed when it comes to suicide.
I'm cursed with everything, man.
All right. I felt that way when I was 22, and look at me now. I'm only mildly cursed
and miserable.
No. I'm on top of the world. I really am.
Well,
Jared, you can make something of your life. You can do whatever you want. I don't want to sound cliche, but you can't just walk around angry.
That's the thing. I've been trying for the last 2 years. I've been traveling all over the country for the last 2 years because I had been in the Army, and I had gotten out of that because of they had had a medical procedure done on me, a spinal tap or a lumbar puncture, however you want to pronounce it, done to me. And it didn't go right, and it was they had a... Army nurse that was just learning how to do this stuff do it, and it screwed up my back, so I have a screwed up back, and like I've been playing music for like 5 years trying to get noticed, and nobody notices. And
yeah, well, listen, nobody noticed. Hold on a second. Nobody notices. You're 20, for Christ's sake. I was just driving over here thinking about how I never made a nickel until I was 31. I mean, listen, I don't want to beat up a guy who's suicidal, but Jared feels sorry for himself. He's got a chip on his shoulder, and he's a pain in the ass. He's got to get some friends, reach out, and you know what I mean?
I think that is the point, is that people that are really...
Cypress Hill's here.
The whole gang.
Yeah, come on in, guys.
The people that are really down and out that in their lives usually find meaning through other people.
Yeah.
I know attachment is his issue, and it might be unrealistic, but to try to be of service to others in some capacity.
Right. The world is your oyster.
Yeah.
I mean, because that's
Christ.
I will talk over that every time, you son of a bitch. I swear to God, I was drunk or kidding when I said that. It was one or the other, possibly both. You know, I do a lot of the shows loaded, Drew.
No kidding.
All right, everybody.
Well, who doesn't?
Cypress Hill is here. Be real, I thought you were not coming in tonight.
Oh, I would not let you down, man. I mean,
you didn't let me down. I thought you weren't coming in. I was excited.
Well, we... man, and after piece of vegetable that I gave him last time,
The herb, yeah.
Maybe he forgot.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're sorry for our tardiness, gentlemen.
That's all right.
You got Adam high last time you were here?
No, we didn't.
I didn't get him high.
How dare you? How dare you? He just gave me drugs. That's
I just
all.
Gave him drugs.
That's right. I have seen him high with
what?
Snoop.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're getting high with other people now, man?
Well, you know, I know other guys, other rock stars that smoke
He's
weed.
Bigger
what
now.
Can
That's
I
my
say?
Main man name.
That's right.
My man made main name.
Right. Yeah, we may have to head out to the car later tonight, too. I'll tell you what, it's been a while. All right, what are we plugging here, Cypress Hill? Because we love Cypress Hill and we love to plug.
Well, we have yet another gig. We have a few things going on, obviously. Right now we're recording a new studio record and stuff right now.
That's where we came from right now.
That's where we came from. That's why we're so tardy.
That's fine.
But this thing we're doing Friday night is called the 420 Dr. Green Thumb Harvest. It's basically a show we're doing at the Shrine. It's, you know, considered a stoner's holiday.
What's the 420 mean?
I got no clue, man. Somebody made it up.
Really? It's not some police code or call or something
like
that?
I believe it's a code, yeah. It's some sort of code and something else I can't remember. But
does it mean something specific?
Well, somebody decided it did a while ago, and now it does.
What does it mean?
Now it does.
Something to do with weed.
We're, like smoke out?
Yeah, it's a police code. Somebody got busted or something like that, and it's...
But if you tell a guy you're doing a 420 or pulling a 420 or something like that, he knows you're cool, right?
Well, I guess so, yeah. Anytime you mention 420, you
right.
know. Funny thing is... Well, it's Hitler's birthday, too.
Oh, really?
420.
Yeah.
Wow.
Nice.
Interesting.
So, but, you know, we're not by no means celebrating that.
We're not celebrating that.
You know, we're celebrating the stoner holiday.
And that is also going to be with the Cottonmouth Kings. Yes. That's a good group.
Yeah, very good friends of ours. And, you know, they partake in the vegetable, too.
Shocking.
Shocking.
I wouldn't have known that about that group of young men.
No, me neither. I mean, this name is so deceiving.
Yeah. And who else is on that? Drunk with Power, Corporate Avengers. Yeah. Soulfly. Yeah, that's going to be a good show. And that is this Friday at the Shrine Expo Hall, which is the Shrine, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's $35 day of the show, $30 in advance. And how many does that Shrine hold? A couple thousand?
I think it holds like 4,000 to 5,000. They used to do, I think, the Grammys and the Oscars there once
right.
in a while.
Oscars right. are still there, right?
Oscars are still there. But I think they're going to move it to the Staples Center, maybe.
Oscars?
I don't know. I thought That's I heard nutty. That, but
let
I'm
me,
not sure.
Let me warn you about the Shrine, because Drew and I were there
Uh-oh.
When... what band
Offspring.
Was up on... Offspring,
right? Oh, no, please don't mention that.
No. I don't want to say anything good about the Offspring.
Because Dexter is... How do you say it, Adam? A pussy? Is that how you say it?
Oh, wow.
Okay,
What's going on here?
Keith, go ahead with your story and, you know.
Well, it's not as good as you and whatever you've got going with Dexter. Tell me what's wrong with Dexter. What's the problem with the Offspring?
Well, the thing is, you know, we went on tour with them, as everybody knows, and, you know, they just, I shouldn't say they because I don't got a problem with Offspring.
Right.
You know.
It's Dexter.
I mean, we had a lot of hard times on that tour. Mm-hmm. Times that we didn't need.
Why? What happened?
Well, you know, when you go on tour with people, there's like a camaraderie, you know?
Yeah.
Like, sort of like when we went with Biscuit.
Right.
Everything went hand in hand. We hung out together.
Right.
They made things easy for us, and they didn't really have to. And we didn't really have to be on the tour, which was the same thing
with the Offspring.
You know, we didn't really have to go with them. They asked us to come on, and, you know, we thought it might be cool. And then, during what, halfway through the tour? No, not
in
even
the
that.
First night.
First night, we were having problems, and then they eventually cut our sound checks down, and their crew was like power tripping on us.
Made us move our buses.
I mean, they did everything you could do to like make it inconvenient
right.
for the guys going on before you. And so, you know, I sort of shut up about it through the whole tour. And maintain professionalism, you know what I mean? Because
right.
I'm not going to complain and I'm not going to jump off a tour and break my contract and leave them hanging in spite of, you know, maybe the little things going on. So at the end of the tour, I wrote a story on our website because we do a thing called Soldier Stories. And I I told the truth, you know. I basically spit the truth out there to our fans, let them know how we felt about the tour. And how we got treated, and I guess he read it.
Mm-hmm.
So I seen him at this ESPN thing not too long ago.
Oh.
And I go to shake their hand just, you know, because I thought they were okay guys. I just thought the tour could have been handled a little different.
Right.
So I approached one of them. I approached Noodles, shook his hand, and he was cool. You know, he shook my hand. And I went to shake Dexter's hand, and he pulled his hand away, and he wouldn't say nothing to me.
Wow.
You know, not even giving me a reason. I already knew the reason.
Right.
But I mean, at least say, hey, man, I don't like what you wrote in your story. I think that was messed up. I don't want to shake your hand. I would have took that like, okay, that's, you know, he's a man.
And
but,
have you spoke to him since? That was it? That was the last time you saw him?
This was just like a week ago.
No.
So then, you know, I said, oh, okay, that's cool. And then I saw him later on in the night and I laughed in his face. And then I saw him again later. And I shook Noodle's hand again. I said, hey, look, you know, me and you, we don't have any problems in spite of whatever whatever's been said and whatever his problem is. And I know he read your tour journal, man, and, you know, he's tripping on that. And I said, well, you know, me and you are cool. And as I was walking away, I yelled over to him, I hope you liked what I wrote in my journal.
Yeah, you guys are the wrong. I mean, you guys are really, it's like crossing the mafia. I'd be nice.
No, you know, we're
Cypress Hills.
We're nice guys, man. You know,
I know you are.
But, you know, I mean, you know, I didn't try to diss Offspring. I just thought that they could have handled it a little better. You know, they made us not want to be on the tour, and I just spoke freely and honestly about it, and he didn't like it, and, you know, hey, I'm sorry, but...
Well, now I hate the Offspring too, Drew.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, the reason they came up.
Oh, sure, yeah. Well, yeah.
Okay, yeah. What was the reason they came up?
That
was a rant.
We saw the Offspring. It was at a Acoustic Christmas, KRock Acoustic Christmas at the Shrine. They were playing. People were bouncing up in that upper balcony, and I thought the goddamn thing was going to come down.
It looked like it was going to collapse.
It does got a lot of spring in it. It's like a 3-meter board in the Olympics. It's got a lot of bounce. And I'm guessing when you guys play and the Cottonmouth Kings play and some of these other bands play, there's going to be some shaking going on. So all I'm saying is...
Be careful. Don't be under it.
If you're under it, do what I did. Is I put one of those big popcorn boxes on my head, one of those buckets, you know, in case the thing came down.
Sure.
At least you got a helmet.
Some protection and some lubricant.
Right.
Yeah. In the form of imitation
lubricant's
butter.
Lubricant's always good.
All right. So that is this Friday, everybody.
That's this Friday.
Let's take ourselves some phone calls, and we'll hear something from Cypress Hill. Are we hearing something off the live CD?
Or whatever you guys want. I mean, hey, it's your pick.
But first.
Okay. But first. Oh, we're taking a break.
Yeah.
First. Well, you know, these guys just showed up, so I was like, we just got started.
Once again, we apologize.
That's all right. You guys, you know, we're not going to cross.
He said enough already.
We'll be right back.
I was going to say the Offspring was here. Cypress Hill is here.
Oh.
Cypress Hill. Hold on.
Low blow.
Cypress Hill and the Hizzy.
Blow.
And we'll be back.
Love Lines with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
1-800-LOVE-191.
Bow, wow, wow. Bow, wow.
The Buzz. Hi, this is Dexter
and Noodles
from The Offspring, and you're listening to Loveline with that asshole Adam Carolla and that guy that's full of himself, thinks he always knows what he's talking about, Dr. Drew.
I hate that guy.
I could do better than that.
There you go. All right, Cypress Hill is here tonight. Be Real is here, Bobo is here, and Chef Ernie.
And Dexter isn't here.
Bam!
Boom!
We will hear something off, I think, the Live at the Fillmore CD, I'm not mistaken. I am mistaken. We're not hearing that. We're going to hear it off the Skull and Bones. Yes.
Exigos on Espanol anymore?
All right.
Well, you know, we got a lot of records.
All right.
I'll just keep the live one.
All right. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll take a call, and then we'll hear something from Cypress Hill. Sarah?
Yes?
You're 21?
Yes.
What's up?
Okay. I have a question. Okay. I've been comparing, I live with a girl, my roommate, I'm in college, and I believe that my inner vaginal lips are large.
Mm-hmm.
They stick out. They're not inside anymore.
Some women have that. There's actually a procedure to reduce that sometimes. Some women really get...
Is it abnormal, though, or is it perfectly fine?
It's like, perfectly fine.
Get in the way of anything?
Not really. It's perfectly fine.
It's just more to adventure with.
Yeah. It's gonna, though. You're 21. Yeah, at 65, it ain't going to be pretty down there. Someone put an M80 down there.
A little bit more to tug on.
Right.
M80.
Yeah, you like that.
Because my roommate's...
Yeah, you know what happens when you put an M80 in a mailbox?
Shred.
It's going to have that look.
They want to at least describe it like a complex orchid or something.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, you got a good 45 years for you.
Yeah, there's always snip, snip, tuck, tuck, and we don't give a...
They do have procedure. But it's nothing to worry about. It's fine.
It's totally normal?
Totally normal.
Yeah. You'll find a guy. He'll be thrilled. He'll enjoy that. It's more vagina for him.
Yeah.
All right?
All right, thanks.
All right, baby. You're fine. All right? And, yeah, they do have, I mean, it's a
reductions,
newer plastic surgery.
Vaginal
no.
They have that. Few things.
Yeah.
That rejuvenation. I was reading an article about the rejuvenation procedure. That is actually done to try not just to create the barrier for the groom to believe he's being with a virgin. They have to fool a gynecologist, because the families get to choose a doctor of their choosing, send the girl there to prove or to have her certified as a virgin.
Really?
Isn't that wild?
Nice.
This is these guys that do these reparative procedures.
You can't recreate that, man. Maybe the feeling.
Evidently, this guy does it because he has a huge reputation for doing that.
You know, he's been deflowered, though, man.
I tell you, I would like to. I'd like to go thumb through that before and after book over. You know, when you go to the plastic surgeon, you can look at some before and after pictures. You just sit there and stare at vagina all day long. Just like a scrapbook of vagina. That's why it'd be great to be a plastic surgeon. So you have a family album full of boob and vagina.
Right.
Good times.
Wow. Zach?
Yeah.
You're 17?
Yeah.
On with Cypress Hill. What's going on?
Actually, it's not a question. My girlfriend and I, we've been together for like 9 months, right? And we've been having sex for probably about 7 of the months. And we've been totally naked with each other. We've been like laid in bed all day. We took showers and whatnot. But like when we take a shower, the lights will be off. When we're in bed, she'll be covering herself up with a blanket. Or she'll have her arm over her chest. I've never, ever seen her boobs. Never, ever.
Really?
And I don't know. And it's not like she knows. She doesn't show anybody, because I know other people that have seen them. I know.
Wait, did they report anything unusual?
What do you mean?
Those that have been lucky
enough boobs,
have had a sighting?
They didn't say anything. Like, there's nothing wrong with them.
Have you asked her what the problem is?
She just says she's not comfortable yet.
But you can't suss out what shape they're in by, you know, feeling them and all that?
I could, but it's just the fact that she won't show me. It's driving me insane.
So Adam's asking,
are they big?
Oh, the average size, probably C cup.
Mm-hmm. And have you sucked on them?
yeah.
I have to ask a question.
Where did you go to finishing school?
Yeah, that's a very tough question. Yeah.
I have to ask a
hard-hitting
question.
Have you pinched them and twisted them?
Yeah, I've been all around them. I just never gotten like
you've
a clear
never just
view.
Seen them.
He's yeah, I've never been able to like straight look at them.
I see. Well, how old is she?
17.
Uh-huh. Is she religious?
Not really.
Sometimes 17-year-old girls are a little bit freaked out about
maybe she's just
bodies.
Insecure about you know?
Yeah, she's kind of got a bad past, and I was wondering if that could maybe be
what's up?
Part of it. Not much. She's had, like, a bunch of, like, 4 or 5 different stepdads, and one of them was, one of them specifically was pretty bad to her. He didn't rape her, but he, like, molested her. He used to touch her, and this is when she was, like, 9.
Yeah.
So.
All right. So she's kind of freaked out.
Yeah, she's kind of freaked out about that, and it took her a long time for her to come clean about that, so I'm thinking that's a really big deal to her.
Yeah. How do you take a shower in the dark, by the way?
I don't know, candles with, like, red coverings over them, so it gives a real low light.
Holy Christ.
You know,
she is a girl, right, downstairs.
Sure, she ain't into witchcraft, dude.
you are touchy-touchy down there, right?
Yeah, that's fine. I've been able to see every other part of her body, but...
All right.
Not
you just take it slow. I mean,
you'll see him one day.
Yeah.
I hope so. I mean, it's been 9 months. I mean,
man, if it gets that bad, just put a pocket light under there, you know, under the sheets, and just take a peek, you know.
I've tried, like, sneak attack, and she's pretty quick.
Yeah. Wow. You know, they have those mechanics glasses that actually have, like, lights in them. You ever see those?
Yeah.
They're like shop glasses with a couple of high beam lights on them for working on carburetors
and
stuff.
Well, I know surgeons wear these things, come over your head with a big headlight on.
Well, you know, he could surprise her and, you know, put the clapper in his room.
Yeah.
Wow. Right when she's not expecting it.
Send her screaming for therapy. Zach, just take it slow, because you're probably going to have to move at her pace.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, you'll probably be disappointed when
you
actually
do
see him.
Think about the clapper.
I do. You know, seeing is a good half of it for me. I mean, personally, I like to see something so I can hurry up, get home, and masturbate to what I saw when I'm with a woman. I know it sounds like a retarded strategy, but it's something I've kept since high school.
Hey, well, if it works for you, man.
That's right. Who are we to question
your methods?
That's right.
Over here.
True, you like to see something too, though, right?
Oh, yeah.
You do, right?
Yeah, of course.
And you think I'm weird for trying to incorporate the mirror. But you guys like the mirror, right?
The mirror.
The mirror.
You know, you like to position yourself in front of that full-length mirror so you can see. It's like, oh, my God, I'm getting light. Look at me.
Oh, okay. I give myself
a thumbs up every once in a while, or the okay sign.
Yeah, the mirror could be good.
And laugh like a hyena.
Yeah, that's right. You get a little snapshot.
Maniacal laugh.
You don't do that mirror. You guys do the mirror thing, right?
Yeah.
Mirror?
No.
You know, nothing?
What?
You don't? Yeah.
That's not to look at me.
Yeah, but no, it's to look at you getting laid. Huh?
To remind yourself that it's happening.
That's
like
right.
Pinching yourself. You know,
right.
So you're awake.
You take a little mental snapshot there. Juan?
Yes, sir.
You're 26.
Actually, I'm 29.
All right.
I don't know why I said 26, but I am 29.
All right. What's up?
Well, about 4 months ago, I ran into my brother's wife, Leslie. She lives out in Barstow, and well, make a long story short, we ended up hooking up. They're already going through a process of divorce, and now we're still seeing each other, and my brother found out it's a big old mess, and now I'm just wondering what to do, if I should leave her, because I care about her a lot. She tells me she loves me, but she's with other guys, and I'm just confused about the whole thing. I don't know. She's screwing these two 19-year-olds and one 26-year-old, and then she's with me, and my brother's kind of mad at me, and, you know, like I said, they're going through a divorce, but, so what do I do? I mean, should I kick her to the curb? Should I maybe see what happens?
I don't believe a word of what you're saying.
Curbside check-in.
No, he's making this all
he
up.
He is, because why would he bring her name up?
Name
and
is bizarre.
And his brother's and, wife.
Yeah, what, yeah, why are you making up a question like this?
Sorry,
Mentiroso.
Sucio.
All right. Hey, Juan, is your name even Juan?
Yeah, it is.
Really?
I'm not lying about this social situation.
Really? Because it's tough. I know, because the Hispanic dudes don't do the bogus calls. Mm. They don't got that kind of sense of humor.
No, this is
well, I don't know why. They don't screw around that way. It's always white guys who do that call. There's you know, like the biggest bogus call group is the white guy. Black guys, Hispanic guys, Asian guys, never. There's never and women never do it. It's only white
certain
guys.
Certain ethnicities don't have the goofball.
They don't have the goofball gene.
Yeah.
They don't have the jack-off gene like young
well,
white guys
do. Well, how
do
we know this guy's even Mexican?
Well, he says his name is Juan.
Well,
are you Mexican?
Know.
Yeah, actually, I'm Jewish also. My mother's Jewish and my dad's Mexican.
Oh, he switched
see,
it right
I could
now.
Say
he
my name
it.
Is, you know, something too.
Herschel.
Herschel, yeah.
Juan Epstein.
Wait a minute, Juan.
My name is Irving Mendoza.
You're Jewish and Mexican?
Yeah, my mom's Jewish. She's a Russian Turkish Jew, and my dad's Mexican American.
Uh-huh.
They both separated before I was born, but proud to be Jewish. You know, I got a little Jewish blood in me, so
yeah.
It's a good thing.
Well, maybe that's the screwball blood that's in you.
Yeah.
All right. Listen, this girl sounds like trouble. If this is a real call, she's a pain in the ass. She's breaking up. She's two-timing on your own brother with you.
She's telling you she loves you while she's screwing two other guys.
Any of the one things you've described is not a relationship. Somebody who's cheating, somebody who has violated the trust of another family member of yours. It's not. No, this is not okay.
Do you have any other brothers?
She must be very hot. This is the only way a guy could justify this.
I got a few other brothers, actually. I got three other brothers. My youngest...
That's the Mexican side, by the way. Yeah. It's not the Jewish side.
Well, don't worry. Your brother would be next. brother.
But, you know, ask him.
Juan, does she have any kids?
Yeah, she has a baby from my brother.
Come on. That's your nephew.
Come on. What's wrong with you? Throw it to the curb.
Not that it makes a difference, but my brother is adopted. He was adopted when he was a baby.
Oh. Oh, that's completely different then.
Right.
Yeah.
No,
well, I don't know if it is, but...
No.
I could step on my brother's toes because he's not, like, really my brother. Come on, man.
I know. That's
all right.
Cool.
And Juan, you know what this all stemming from? You not being able to find a chick.
Well, this is...
Yeah. Right? Yes. Either that or this girl's incredibly hot and he's justifying all this as a way of staying
with
her.
Is she incredibly hot?
She's pretty. You know, the sex is good, and I enjoy being with her.
Nah,
I
just can't find anybody.
Nah,
Juan, you need to find your own chick.
Really? So there's no hope in this?
It's just easy for you. That's what it is. It's easy, accessible for
you. Not easy.
No, I mean
anything else.
No, I mean her.
Yeah, but he again, nothing else going. It's not even just easy. There's nothing else going on for him.
It's
you've been a rock star too long. You forget what that's like.
Yeah.
Low blow.
Yeah. No, seriously, be real. You get a job over at the Laurie seasoning
all right.
plant over there in
all
Eagle Rock.
Right,
and let's
I'll
see how
stop.
Much tail you bring home.
I'll stop.
You know, regular guys can't get laid, you know?
So hey, I know plenty of regular dudes that get laid.
They
man.
Stumble.
They hang around rock stars.
Ernie over here, he's catching scraps from the band. Are you kidding?
Exactly.
Listen, I know his strategy. Yeah, what do you mean? I'm in a band.
Cooks for him.
And let me tell you something also about Cypress Hill. You got a good look and hang out. You could fake your way into that band, no problem. I don't mean you get up on stage. You just stand around backstage and say, yeah, that's right. I'm in the percussion section. You know,
right on.
This is 25 guys up there. You get lost back there. Just say you're in there. It's like I told everyone I was in Santana's percussion section for many years in high school. They all believed it. They didn't know. Who's going to call me out on it?
Right on.
Told them I played that hollowed out fish.
Yeah.
Got a lot of tail off of that gig. Yeah, tell me the guy playing the fish. You're cooking and playing the fish.
It's going to pick up for you, Chef.
All right. Let's take ourselves a little break. Cypress Hill is here, and I promise we'll hear something from them when we come back.
Loveline, we'll be right back.
I didn't even know that.
I thought I saw him cruising his pimp ride
Where
down
is that?
The street.
In Sherman Oaks. Yeah. I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
All right, we got to hurry up and go to break so we can talk more about where exactly our houses are. Yeah, all right, we'll play a song.
Keep talking about it.
All right, we're on a roll here. Cypress Hill is here. We're going to hear something off the Skull and Bones CD. Mm-hmm. And this one is called Rock Superstar.
So you wanna be a rock superstar and live large, big house, five cars, you're in charge, coming up in the world, don't trust nobody, gotta look over your shoulder constantly. I remember the days when I was a young kid growing up, looking in the mirror, dreaming about blowing up the rock crowd, make money, trip with the honey, sign autographs, and whatever the people want from me. It's funny how impossible dreams manifest in the games that be coming with it. Nevertheless, you got to go from the gusto, but you don't know about the blood, sweat, and losing some of your peers and losing some of yourself through the years past gone by. Hopefully it don't manifest, but the wrong guy, egomaniac in the brainiac, don't know how to act. 48 track studio gangsta max, sign the deal, thinks he's gonna make a meal but never will, till he crosses over steel, filling your head with fantasies. Come with me, strip the sacrifice it takes to make the cheese. You wanna be a rock superstar in the biz and take you from people who don't know what it is. It's not a ship, it's all fun and game, but the price of fame is high. It's some can't pay the way, feel trapped in what you rapping about. Tell me what happened when you lost clout. The route you took started collapsing. No fans, no fame, no respect, no change, no women, and everybody on your shoulder. You wanna be a rock superstar and live large, your big house, five cars, your big charge, coming up in the world, don't trust nobody, gotta look over your shoulder constantly. To be a rock superstar and live large, your big house, five cars, your big charge, coming up in the world, don't trust nobody, gotta look over your shoulder constantly.
People see rock star, you know what I'm saying, but you still trying to get out and work like everybody else, you know. You know, it's a fun job, but it's still a job. There's gonna be another cat coming out looking like me, sounding like me next year. I know this. It'll be a flip side to what you did. Somebody else trying to spin off like some, you know, serious.
If I have big dreams, I'm making big cream. Big shot, heavy hitter on the mainstream, you wanna look trendy in the Bentley. Be a snob and never act friendly. You wanna have big fame? Let me explain what happens to these stars in their big brains. First they get played like all damn day. Long as you sell, everything will be okay. Then you get dissed by the media and fans. Things never stay the same way they began. I heard that some never give fool to the fullest. That's why fools end up dying on a bullet. Think everything's fine in the big time. See me in my legs with the chrome ring shine. So you wanna go far and live large. It ain't all that goes with being a rock star.
So you wanna be a rock superstar and live large. A big house and fine cars and great cars. Coming up from the world, don't trust nobody. Gotta look over your shoulder constantly to be a rock superstar and live large.
I'm chilling in the hotel room lonely, but I thank God I'm with my homies. But sometimes I wish I was back home, but only no radio or videos, cause they show me no love, the phony. Gotta hit the boat solely, so the record gets pushed by Sony. I'm in the middle like Moni, and the press say that my own people disown me. And the best way back is to keep your head straight, never inflate the cranium. You're too worried about them honeys at the Palladium, who just wanna cling on, swing on, and so on. Go on, fall off, the whole roll on to the next rock superstar with no shame. Give him a year and I'll be right out the game, the same as the last one who came before him. Gained fame, started getting ignored. I warned him, assured him this ain't easy. Take it from Weezy, sleazy people wanna be so cheesy. The people
assassin.
Barbecue.
Oh my goodness.
Oh boy.
All right, everybody. All right,
we're talking about great time.
Cypress Hill. And you can find them at the Shrine on the 30th. That's this.
On the 20th.
Oh, 20th. I'm sorry. This Friday, everybody. That is with the Cottonmouth Kings and Drunk with Power and Soulfly and other good bands, and this is going to be a good time. And you can't go wrong with Cypress Hill.
See, he didn't even take a hit yet, and he's already confusing the date.
All right. Yes, I have to get more drugs. Drew, remind me to get more drugs.
Mental note, Adam,
mental
more drugs.
Mental note. Yes, okay.
Right, from Be Real. Thank you. Jessica?
Hello.
Hey, you're 17. What's up?
Yeah, this past weekend I had... I guess you could say more sex than usual than I usually do.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm, like, really sore.
Yeah.
And I'm having, like, a little bit of a white discharge. Yeah. And
why don't you get that checked out?
I don't know. I was going to ask you what it was, Drew.
Did you protect yourself?
It could be an STD, right?
Oh, I hope not. But
well, that's how STDs present. A little discharge, a little pelvic pain, vaginal irritation.
Did you protect yourself?
That's gonorrhea, chlamydia, all those lovely infections present like that.
What's the matter?
All right, because
one of the guys.
He, like, I guess earlier on in the night, I didn't know this, somebody told me this later, said that he had chlamydia, and I didn't know that.
Well, there you go. And as you know, chlamydia causes infertility.
Yeah. But I don't know,
well,
sometimes...
I don't need to be having kids, so that's probably good.
Well, how many guys did you do?
Only two.
Two, uh-huh.
And they didn't wear anything?
No, they didn't.
Was there any whipped cream?
Yeah, it's coming out of her now. I think... By the way, you don't normally brag about having chlamydia unless you have it. Sometimes I'll say it at a party so I can get to the front of the keg line, but... it's not the kind of thing guys will just talk about. So I would believe that this guy has chlamydia or had it.
Yeah.
And you have it. And what's up with you, Jessica, in general?
Why would you be such a bad parent?
Oh, I'm never having kids.
How come?
Ever.
You've called us before, haven't you?
Yeah, I have.
I recognize this voice.
Really?
Isn't that weird? Yeah.
You're good, Drew.
Yeah, isn't that wild?
Yeah, see, you don't smoke weed, fellas. That's what you get. You got a mind.
Right.
Hey, what's up? Were you abused?
No. Oh, God. You guys did this to me last
Yes,
time.
I remember this.
Well, it's because you use the same voice, that abused voice.
No, my voice is, like, so much better than it used to be. I don't have a little girl voice anymore.
Okay, but you're still sleeping around, and you're not using protection. You're not taking care of yourself.
No, I did use protection both times.
Oh, you did? She did.
All four times I did.
So they did wear condoms.
Four times. Four times two penises, though, right?
Yeah.
Did they give you oral sex, either of them?
Yeah, both of them did.
So there could be something that they transmitted from their mouths.
Yeah.
Herpes, that kind of thing. So again, you just got to go Plan Parenthood if you don't have a doctor or any urgent care center. Just get a pelvic exam, see what's going on. They'll probably give you a single dose, actually, of antibiotic, and that'll be that.
You must check yourself.
All right?
I have one more question.
Yeah.
If it's not, like, if he had it once before... Does that mean he always can, like,
transmit it? No, herpes is the one that does that, and warts, but no, not chlamydia. That one's easy to eradicate in men.
That's right.
Maybe I didn't get it.
I got rid of my chlamydia by letting off one of those chlamydia foggers. You drop down your underpants. That's a new one thing. I think Holiday makes them.
No, they haven't. They just let them off in your bedroom.
Oh, I wasn't supposed to put on my underpants?
Right.
Jesus Christ, the thing burnt like hell. I was wondering what
Damn.
That was. You just let it go in the bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good invention. Maybe the crab fogger.
The crab fogger,
special TV offer.
You just pull the tab on the can, set it on the nightstand, and go to sleep.
If you have creepy crawlers.
It'll get rid of crabs, head lice, fleas, ticks, just about anything. Drew, work on that venereal fogger, would you?
Venereal fog.
Yeah.
We will take ourselves a little break. Cypress Hill is here tonight. We're always glad to see these guys, and we'll be back with more of your questions after this.
1-800-LOVE-191.
We'll be right back.
You're listening to Loveline on Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz. Outrageous Talk Radio, 100.7 The Buzz. KQBC, Seattle.
Loveline, fast-growing outlaw radio in North America. No? Anderson says no.
Yeah, I was a beat late. You know why? I got on board a little late. I thought it was the next break. I'm not going to make excuses. That was a 4 or 5. It wasn't a great one for me. Drew?
Yep.
Just making sure you're still alive. Cypress Hill is here. Chef Ernie and Bobo. And
Chef Ernie.
Be Real are all here from Cypress Hill. They're going to be playing with the Cottonmouth Kings and many other bands. That is the 20th. That is this Friday at the Shrine Auditorium. Go down there. See if you can take down that upper deck.
Yeah.
All right. So let's hop back on the phones and speak to Ted. Ted is 19. Ted?
Yeah.
What's up?
All right. I know this girl. She's got herpes on her mouth, and I'm not sure if she has it down there. But I was thinking, should I do anything with her, or should I just avoid that?
Well, most people have it on their mouth.
How do you know she has it on her mouth? You've seen it?
No, I haven't seen it personally, but my cousin is her best friend, and...
Mm-hmm.
It's very common to have it in the mouth.
Okay, can she, like, spread it, down there, though?
That's how it gets down there.
Okay.
Yeah, but you can probably, get with her when she's not having an outbreak and be safe.
Yeah, so many, many people have that herpes virus in the mouth.
But I hear she can get it, like, a couple days before she's contagious and after, or, like, she's contagious... Before she gets bumps on her mouth and after.
Let's stay with me.
All right.
Many people have this in their mouth.
All right.
Okay. Do you hear that much of it being transmitted from the mouth to the genitals? It doesn't happen that much. It's not that common. So people, if they're not having symptoms, usually you can be reasonably safe. Not necessarily, but you can't necessarily be safe with anyone because this virus is so common in the mouth.
Listen to the doctor, man.
All right. You like her, Ted?
Yeah, she's pretty cool.
All right.
That's more important than anything else.
Well, listen, you can get a good deal on her with the herpes. You know what I mean? It's like sometimes you go down to the Sears Outlet Mall out there, and you get like a $900 washing machine for $600. It's got a dent in the side, but you can barely see it. That's what I look at as herpes on a young girl. Get yourself a deal. A girl you couldn't normally afford, and she's accessible all of a sudden.
He knows right? how to bargain.
Yeah, go down to the herpes outlet mall.
The bargaining chips.
Yeah.
All right, what? Ted. If I ever got married and had to get a divorce, I'd call you as my lawyer, man.
Yeah. I'd get in there.
Yeah.
You'd keep your hopped up Denali and your Sherman Oaks Palace if right you had on. Me as a lawyer.
Cool.
William?
Yes.
You're 19?
That's right.
What's up?
My wife has constant migraines all the time. Anything can set them off. She has a slight skull fracture that made them worse. She got it from an ex-boyfriend a few years ago.
These aren't migraines.
What happened with the ex-boyfriend?
Well, they were roughhousing, and he's kind of a dick, and she collected his elbow into the back of her head. And this is after the migraines started. She's been diagnosed with them. Multiple doctors have treated her. They give her Percocet, Vicodin.
That's not migraine. That is not migraine. Okay, first of all, that's a bad headache, but that's not migraine.
Well, it's roughhousing, and the guy cracked her skull?
Beat the crap out of her.
He dropped the elbow.
There's many things missing in this story here. Okay, first of all, give up the idea that these are migraines. They aren't migraines. Secondly, they weren't roughhousing. He smashed her skull.
Actually, I was there for that part. They were roughhousing, and he just flat out took it to the edge and did something he never should have done.
That's called beating on her, though.
Yeah, that's not rough.
That's right. I beat on him for it.
All right. Hey, don't have any kids, would you? Do us all a favor.
And let's stop talking in riddles. Let's just talk about what's going on here.
What the hell were you doing there?
This was before we were dating. I was good friends with him.
Yeah.
That's how I met her.
How does that work, though, when you're hanging out with your buddy and he's wrestling with his girlfriend? I mean, what do you
there
do?
There was a whole bunch of his. It turned into a tickle war between them. They ended up on the floor, and we just ignored him for a while.
I see. And then he whacked her, and then you whacked him?
I didn't hit him. I just pushed him back. She was holding her head, and he just kept doing it. So I just pushed him back and said, hey, just get away from her.
He kept beating on her after he threw the elbow?
He kept tickling her.
You run with a pretty fast crowd there, William.
Oh, I don't run with him anymore.
All right, so
she has bad headaches, and now she's on opiates.
Yeah, she
has
bad headaches, and she won't take the Percocet or the Vicodin or any of that anymore.
What is she taking?
At the moment, nothing.
Why doesn't she take that?
Because she'll take it, the headache will go away for a half an hour.
And they get worse.
And then all of a sudden she comes down off of the Percocet or the Vicodin, and it just makes it 10 times worse.
Yeah, the opiates.
Her vision will blank out.
Yeah, the opiates will make it worse. The opiates definitely make the headache syndrome worse.
So what should she do?
What happened is a while back, a friend of her said, hey, why don't you try marijuana? It works for my migraines. And she tried it, and it works. Completely goes away in 5 minutes.
All right.
And I'm pretty anti-drug. I want nothing to do with it. But of course, I'm not a doctor. I'm an engineer.
Mm-hmm.
So I was wondering what your take was.
Well, if it works, another marijuana-related success story, right, Cypress Hill?
I can sort of speak on that because my mother had these things called cluster headaches,
mm-hmm.
and what they tried to remedy her with was with oxygen, and what that would do is it would slowly bring the headache down. But, you know, it didn't do anything to stimulate her appetite or anything like that. And one day I just said, here, this thing ain't really working. Try this. I mean, I don't know if it's going to work, but maybe it'll, you know, at least get your appetite up there. And she started to smoke it, and it would relieve her a little bit, a little at a time. And after she'd get hungry, and it, you know, it'd help her out with her other therapy and stuff like that. So it worked for her because she doesn't use the oxygen anymore, and she doesn't get the headaches anymore.
But she's not still smoking the pot.
Yeah.
She's still smoking the pot.
Yeah. Yeah. Whenever she feels it coming on, she'll smoke a little bit, and then it won't, you know, it won't affect her, and she's been all right ever since then.
That's exactly what happens with her. She'll feel it coming on, and if she catches it in time, she'll smoke a little bit and it won't even affect her.
How often is she doing that?
Once every 2 days.
Yeah.
And it's just a little bit at a time.
Well, it's hard to know if she is an addict, if she has an alcoholic.
Yeah, she's not, because she didn't want the Vicodin or the Percocet. She would have been all over that.
She doesn't drink at all.
No, I understand. But if she inherited the gene for alcoholism, this could be a treacherous intervention for her.
Yeah, but wouldn't she be on the Vicodin or the Percocet?
There's a lot more going on here, I guarantee you.
Really?
I guarantee you.
Because she was hooked up with the violent guy? Why was she running around with this pro wrestler?
Well, he's definitely not a pro wrestler, and to her, he started out as a nice guy, and he ended up using her, spent all her money, and drove her car. He didn't have one. Drove her car all the time. She never had it.
Right, but why would she stay with a guy like this? Why would she get hooked up with a guy like this?
Was something up
with her?
Oh, yeah. William's the wrestler.
Well, actually, she, when it started getting bad, she didn't really notice it at first.
Right.
That's the point.
Gradually, and all of her friends pointed that out, and she dropped him.
Okay.
Yeah, after he fractured her skull.
All right. Yep. Well, listen. She's smoking the weed. It's helping out with her condition, and I say, what the hell?
My next question is, it's related.
Uh-huh.
She has endometriosis.
See, this is
why. What's that from?
Chronic pelvic pain. This is chronic headaches, chronic pelvic pain, personality.
And I don't know if the marijuana will affect that in any way.
How's her personality? Is she screwball?
A little chaotic?
No, she's a sweetheart.
Little chaos in her life?
Yeah, there is a little bit of chaos.
Yeah, little chaos.
Life. Yeah. I'm between jobs at the moment. We're not living together because I'm about to go to my new job, but I don't have the apartment in that town yet.
Uh-huh.
Just keep your eyes open, William. It's going to be an interesting ride you're on here. Believe me, trust me.
Yeah,
this is gonna erupt into a lot of interesting drama. Guaranteed.
Good luck. William, though, I like he's really like a publicist for batterers. they were roughhousing.
Yeah, the whole thing, his level of denial is profound.
Everything.
A little tickle war.
Yeah,
little Carl Malone type elbow in the key, and back to a little tickling. Yeah.
He was the ref that day.
Michelle?
Yes?
You're 17?
Hi.
What's up?
Will you get mad at me if I say hi to Cypress Hill real quick?
No, go ahead.
Hey.
Hello.
What's up?
I used to get stoned to your CD all the time.
Whoa. Me too.
All right. Anyway, so when I was 15, right before I turned 16, I got pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
And when I turned 16, I got married. And I got pregnant again. Then I left my husband, and then he divorced me.
How old was he?
Right now he's 20.
Okay.
And so I'm pregnant, and I told him that I got an abortion.
Right.
But I really didn't, and I don't know if I should get one or not.
So you're pregnant now.
Right.
Could you give this baby up for adoption?
Uh-uh.
Why not?
Well, because, once you see it, it's like, wow.
Yeah, I felt that about cars, though, and then 6 months later got rid of them. You couldn't do that with a kid? Is that different? Yeah, a car is like that for a guy,
but
right?
Still, use your head a little bit. You'd rather have the child destroyed than go through.
You're not attached or anything right away.
Yeah, I mean, she's being honest. It's kind of stupid, but honest. I know what she's saying. All right, you're saying once you see that child, then now it's a person.
Have it whisked away immediately. Have it taken away. I mean, again, you're electing to have it destroyed as opposed to going through risking feeling a little connected to it.
Right.
Isn't that, on behalf of the child, just the logic of that bothers me.
Well, how far along are you?
3 months.
And what about the dad, or what about your ex-husband? What kind of guy is he?
I left him because he hit me, and he wouldn't let me go to college or...
I see.
Again, she's not saying, I don't want to carry the child. It's going to disrupt my life. She's not saying any of those things.
Yeah.
She's just saying, I don't want to see it.
Right.
What about the kid you have? Where's that one?
With me.
Uh-huh. How's that kid doing?
Oh, he's awesome, but his dad just, nothing.
Yeah. And who's helping you out?
My parents.
All right. And really, was it... you know, I hate to beat on you now when you're down, but did you need to get pregnant again? I mean,
I didn't mean to.
I know, but you didn't do anything to stop it either.
Did you think that was going to keep him around?
I didn't want to keep him around.
I see.
I wanted things to work out, but...
Okay. Well, you know? how about adoption? And then you can go through that whole thing later on in life where you track them down and you have that reunion and they're kind of disappointed.
Well, I'm just saying I couldn't do that. I wouldn't.
Well, that or get fixed after that so it never happens again and again and again.
Well, I don't think anyone will fix a 17-year-old, will they?
No.
It's a sad state we live in, but it's true. So you want to get an abortion then?
Well, I don't know if I should or not.
All right, I'll tell you what you should do. Why don't you go down to Planned Parenthood and just talk to a counselor and see what they say?
Well, I don't want to bring another kid in this world that's not going to have a dad. You know what I'm saying?
You don't have to, you know, it doesn't have to be that way. You can, like they said, put it up for adoption. It'll have a father and mother, you know.
They'll take care of it. Very, very capable.
Or, you know, worst case scenario, a lesbian couple. Maybe folk singers or something like that.
Why would that be the worst case?
Well, you know, the lesbians.
Worst case, they can stay with Michelle.
They'll take that kid and they'll be using him for a golf tee inside 10 minutes. I know those lesbians were kids.
No, I'm saying
teeing up a bucket of range balls right off that kid's head. Michelle?
What?
Okay, you're confused, and rightfully so. You have a decision to make, and you have to make it soon, and that's why you should go down to Planned Parenthood and talk to somebody.
Absolutely. Sit down and talk
who's
to
got time, all
yeah,
right?
Yeah, just think about it for a while. Don't rush to any decision.
Yeah, but don't think about it for 6 months.
Yeah, don't think too long.
I don't know. I just already said I would either get an abortion or I keep it.
Right. Mm-hmm. But see, you understand that's what you call a decision. And that's one you have to make, and you have to sit down with somebody and talk to them about it, okay? You're not going to figure it out tonight.
Well, I know. I mean, I've talked about it.
All right, baby.
No, with a professional.
No, I have.
Who?
My counselor.
All right.
Mm. Still, do us a favor and go down to Planned Parenthood, would you?
Mm-hmm.
Because we have referred to a lot of people over there, and they do add a little clarity and insight to a confusing situation.
1-800-230-PLAN.
I'll tell you, what a utopia we'd be living in if all these screwballs would stop getting pregnant. It's really, I mean...
They could stop it.
Yeah, I mean, this she's got a young son, and this kid... you know, we hope it turns out for the best, but statistically, he ain't in great shape.
He ain't in great shape.
No, and neither are we, by the way. Mark Carstereo is now in jeopardy. Do you understand? That's what I worry about.
My rims, too, then.
Yeah, that's right. The rims, maybe the glass packs on the Denali.
Yeah.
Isaiah?
Yeah.
You're 24?
Yeah.
What's up?
Yeah, I just wanted to tell Cypress Hill I was kind of disappointed because I didn't know what 420 was.
Oh, okay.
It's the National Smoking Hour.
Yeah, it's the National Smoking Hour.
That's
It represents a lot of different things. But, you know,
hold on a second. Isaiah, listen to me. Don't be disappointed in them, because the only reason they couldn't remember is because they're so baked.
That's right.
That they just couldn't recall it.
They're busy participating in the smoking hour daily.
Busy smoking. They don't have time for that.
Anytime you're going to buy a sack, you're thinking of Cypress Hill. You know what I mean?
Hey, well, you don't have to stop thinking that way, bro. Damn, hey, it's only a number.
It's just the memory.
My birthday. If anything, my birthday should be the damn stoner holiday, June 2nd.
All right, what is that? Seven?
Sad, though.
Is it, oh, that, 6'2"?
I stopped smoking weed when I was like 14.
Oh, well, that's all right, man. There's nothing wrong with that.
No,
you know, there's nothing.
Yeah.
I can actually remember a whole lot more now.
Yeah, you remember things like when the National Smoking Hour is. You guys can't remember that.
Yeah, see, I can't remember that.
What were we talking about right now?
All right, Isaiah.
I just wanted to also let you guys know that I am a musician.
Oh, right on, man.
And I've been playing guitar for 11 years, bass for 4, and drums for a year.
Well, you keep at it, man, you know.
Damn. All right.
You keep at it, man.
All right. And by the way, when a guy says he plays 8 instruments, it's like when a guy says he's holding down 5 jobs.
Well, see, Bobo plays like 8 instruments.
Oh, wait a minute. Except for Bobo. Bobo, you play 8 instruments?
Yeah,
but he ain't holding down 5 jobs.
Right. I got one job.
What are your instruments, Bobo?
You know, my main instrument, drums, Latin percussion,
play a little bass, a little guitar, some keyboards.
How about that hollowed out fish?
Yeah,
sometimes he plays for it with himself, too. Mm-hmm.
Triangle. Skin flute, too.
No, yeah.
Well, that's nine instruments.
gives a lot of good sounds tonight.
We'll talk to Christina. Christina?
Yeah, I'm here.
You're 21. What's up?
Well, my question was, I've been married for about 2 years now, and me and my husband, we've had sex like every which way you can possibly think of, mm-hmm. except for anally.
I see.
That's
and
next.
He really wants to try it, and I'm just kind of like...
Do you want to try it?
Uptight about it. I mean, in a way I do, but then I don't because I heard it hurts really bad.
Yeah.
And
so why
I don't know what else comes along with it. I mean, what else happens when you do that?
You can bleed and tear and cause hemorrhoids and fissures and all kinds of abscesses.
Okay, and
lovely.
If you tear, what happens? Well, does that wait for that to heal or what?
You can end up with chronic problems.
But it doesn't. You know,
or you might like it.
Get a little lube going, warm you up with some wine coolers. Put on
wine
a little Al Green. Yeah.
What are you doing with
that? How's that
going to
help?
Get you in the mood. Relax you a little bit.
Well, I mean, I'm usually relaxed.
Listen, I'll tell you how it helps. You ever see those Civil War movies where a guy's got to have his leg amputated? So what do they do? They give him about a half bottle of brandy. They get him out of his mind. They cut his leg off.
They give him a piece of wood to chew, bite on.
That's what I do.
I don't want to
give her a wooden spoon and a half bottle of brandy. What?
I don't want to feel sick while I'm doing it. I want to be relaxed.
Listen, I'm not saying down a pony keg. I'm saying have a wine cooler. Loosen yourself up.
A wine cooler is nothing.
Whatever it takes,
well,
baby.
Then
I'm not
a pony keg.
Well, have you guys ever tried it before?
Sure, I've been nailed. Oh, you mean done it to a woman? Sure.
I would hope you would do it to a woman.
Yeah, it's good times. But, you know, I don't have a real big penis.
It's interesting.
So, yeah, I remember when my dad got me my first butt plug. Yeah, my dad started me early. For some guys, it was T-ball. For me, it was a butt plug.
You know? Can also try some toys. That, you know, there's like the booty beads. You know, you can try that too.
Right.
I don't think
where are we going here, guys?
All right, wait until your 10th anniversary.
How should I get myself comfortable with it?
Well, my 10th anniversary coming up this summer.
Is that
the anal anniversary?
Well, I know your 20th is silver. I think your 30th is gold. Your 40th is platinum. And your 10th is anal.
It's anal. Okay.
Yeah. Well, I think I saw a De Beers commercial where they're talking about that.
You got to prep for it, yeah.
You have the shadow on the wall.
That's right. Bum, 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 bum.
Pow.
Zip. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Ah! Bum, 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 bum. Oh! All right. Listen, she just take it slow, and, you know, if it hurts, you can stop.
The most sensitive of all love tunnels.
Don't force it. You can have pucker problems.
We will take ourselves a little break. Cypress Hill is here tonight.
Breaking spokes.
Drew, you got to start limbering up for your 10th anniversary.
Yeah.
And you need someone to, you know, like a pin cushion to experiment on, or are you okay?
I just wanted to borrow those graduated anal plugs you have.
Step up.
Yeah.
I'll start you off with a number 3 and
starter
kit. Have you on number 7 before the week's out, all right?
Give them a starter kit.
We'll be back.
Loveline.
100.7 The Buzz.
Yep, Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew over there. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Bobo, Be Real, and Chef Ernie are all here from Cypress Hill.
Bam!
They'll be playing with Soulfly and the Cottonmouth Kings. That Cottonmouth Kings is a good band.
Yeah, they're very good friends of ours, man.
Good guys.
My man Big Lou over there, and everybody's over there waiting for us at the Rainbow right now. Big Marv, Big Red, and they're just waiting with the vegetables, man.
A lot of big guys in that band.
Yeah, there's a lot of big dudes, yeah.
And they're all going to be together on Friday, this coming Friday,
yes.
At the Shrine.
Can I add something right quick,
ahead.
Man? it's aside from that, you know, we're doing our smoke out again this year. It's going to be really big. But what we're doing right now at the Key Club every Sunday night is we're hosting this thing called Battle of the Bands, and we're giving local bands in California a chance to earn a spot to open up the smoke out on the main stage and on the second stage. So, you know, we just want people to know about that. So, you know, come down to the Key Club and support their local bands. And
how does it work? Who votes on it?
Well, we want the fans to come down there and vote on it. Like, you know, crowd participation, you know what I mean? Let the crowd choose the bands instead of having, you know, judges and stuff like that.
And you'll pick one band out of however many bands you see over the next few months?
Well, what we're doing is like a playoff thing. You know, we'll put all these bands up against each other, and then whoever wins proceeds to the next
level,
you know, round and stuff like that. And at the end of, or at the beginning of October, we'll choose the band. The two bands actually that will open up the big stage and in the side stage. So
That'll be a pretty big break for whoever that band is, because the smokeouts are pretty big, right?
I mean, exactly. Last year we had 60,000 people. This year we're hoping to get 80, 85.
Can you imagine 60,000 people not remembering where they parked their car?
Not just where their car keys are.
Just wandering the parking lot for 4 hours after the gig.
Well, where did my friends go?
What's the date of that going to be this year?
It should be the first weekend in October. I don't know what the number, the date.
And what is this, like the fourth one?
Yeah, this is going to be the fourth one, yeah.
Yeah, it's so weird, and I think it's one of those another one of those things where you know you're getting old fast. When new stuff has been around for a little while.
Yeah.
I mean, I was talking to someone the other night about Ozfest, and it's going in its seventh or eighth year.
Yeah.
To me, that's just a brand new idea. Yeah, not seven, 8 years old.
But hey, how come you guys don't put any political figures to sort of make your case for you guys? You know what I mean?
We actually are a part of Normal, so basically, you know, they work on all the legislation stuff and
why isn't there a political figure though that helped? I mean, there's 60,000 people. You think somebody would want to lead that?
Well,
group?
You know, I don't think there's any person that actually with any kind of power or clout or any sort of high position wants to come out and speak freely about it. You know, being that they might risk their position, you know what I mean?
So bring a new one in. You know what I mean? There's 60,000 people.
I know. But I think Bill Clinton was probably the biggest figure, but, you know, he had to sort of, like, you know, hide the fact and well, not hide it, but actually, like...
That he kept vegetable around the Oval Office?
Yeah, I think so. I think somebody said that in one of his last speeches, he said something like that people shouldn't be, you know, put in jail for smoking marijuana. And I think that was a pretty big thing to say for a guy in his position.
Let me say to the people of America and the nations of the world that I hate your ass.
Right on.
I swear to God I do.
Yeah.
Chris?
Hello?
You're 31?
Yeah.
What's up?
Well, I've done a lot of acid over the course of my life.
Uh-huh.
And enjoyed all of it. But wondering if I've messed up my serotonin levels.
Oh, absolutely. I see this all the time. Do you still see trailers?
No.
Because that's the group that really gets severe depressions, is if you're still having visual disturbances. And, of course, if you're still having visual problems, it's because of a damage to the visual cortex in the brain.
Well, she's not having that.
But the other thing we see is chronic anxiety depressions. And the depressions are really quite intense and don't respond well to medication. So.
Hey, do you ever, like, lose track of where you are and find yourself somewhere else that you never, you know, you didn't plan on going?
No.
Because I remember the first time I visited this show, this guy called in and said that he used to drop a lot of acid.
Yeah.
But he hadn't in a long time. And I guess the day before he called the show, he said that he was driving somewhere that was, like, maybe a five-minute drive for him.
Yeah.
By the time he realized and like snapped out of it, he was like 3 hours away from where he was actually supposed to be.
Yep. Wow. That happened.
That's a bad trip.
How much acid have you done, Chris?
Oh, I don't know. I'm guessing between 50 and 100 hits.
Yeah, well, usually 50 is where people. I have a threshold question I ask people when they come in for treatment for addiction.
That's why I call.
Do you have money?
How many times have you done acid? If they say something like 50, they're going to be on medication. That's it.
regardless of any, like...
If they're absolutely not depressed, I mean, absolutely, I cannot detect any symptoms of depression, which, by the way, I've never seen that case, then I would still watch them because depression is coming.
Okay. I mean, it's been years, but...
It usually comes on about 10 years after you stop using.
Oh, okay. Okay, and see, my PMS has gotten a lot worse.
But that's a mood.
Depression-wise.
But that's the mood instability.
But that's the serotonin levels drop right before your period begins.
Right.
All right, so what should she do?
Obviously, not yours.
Go get, look, there's new Seraphim now, which is specifically for...
No, I don't want to do any prescriptions.
Well, unfortunately, because it's brain damage, you have to fight this with very powerful chemicals.
What about 5-HTP, though?
Will not even come close.
Hey,
I'm telling you that even with very powerful chemicals, this is a difficult thing to treat.
Listen, Einstein, you did a truckload of acid.
Yeah.
What's wrong with doing a little?
When I was 19, I ate about 4 boiled coyote buttons and stayed up all night, but felt no effect.
Yeah. Why would you
object to using something that is known to be safe, been used millions of times?
I have no proof that it's known to be safe, though.
Well, there's a few tens of millions of prescriptions and decades of experience, as opposed to
what made you think the acid was going to be safe?
Yeah, I mean that's the thing. Yeah. She had some guy with a full beard and hepatitis handing her a piece of toilet paper at a fog hat concert.
Go ahead, man. It'll make you feel good.
Gladly shoved it in her mouth, but when a guy with a PhD says she should take some pill that's been handled by guys with gloves in a sterile environment, it's like the man's trying to poison me now. Forget it. Your little plan ain't going to work.
Right. That's ridiculous.
Listen, if you've done enough drugs, street drugs, and you put enough stuff in your mouth, this is the least of your worries. Believe me.
Whoa.
George?
Yes?
You're 23. What's up?
Yes, well, my question's actually for Cypress Hill.
Yeah, okay.
What's up, man?
What's up, homie?
Man, I've been a fan of you guys for like 6 or 7 years, man, since high school.
Wow.
Well, number one, I wanted to ask you guys, after Friday, when's you guys' next performance, and where is that going to be?
After Friday, our next performance. Wow.
I think it's in Arizona.
You guys have anything lined up?
Well, we got something in Arizona the next day, but I mean, that's Arizona. I don't think our next thing is till like the smokeout in October.
Well, he's in San Francisco.
That's right. We're doing a smokeout in San Francisco. I forgot about that. Right. Yeah.
How does that work? You just put a big fan on the smokeout you're doing out here and blow it over to San Francisco?
We're going to do it like smoke signals, you know what I mean?
Yeah. How do you say we're baked?
Yeah.
Hey, be real.
Yeah,
I want to know, I heard that beef that you guys have, or I don't know, the little incident that you had with Ice Cube. What was that all about?
Oh, well, you know, that was a long time ago. Wow. We've made up since then, but you know, it was a question over original material that we recorded.
Well, that was a while ago.
Yeah. That he used, and you know, we called him on it, and you know, it turned into a big hassle, but it's all over now. So
did you get any money out of it?
Nah, there was no money exchanged.
Oh.
We got a different sort of satisfaction from that.
I see.
Want more pot?
No. I wish. That would have been good.
Michael?
Hello?
Hey, you're 17. What's up?
Yeah, my girlfriend and I have a problem. About 4 times when I fingered her, she's bled.
She a virgin?
No.
She's not a virgin?
No.
You wearing a graduation ring?
No.
Did it hurt her?
She hasn't really said, like, each of the times she said it doesn't really hurt, but the last time she said maybe there was, like, a little throbbing or something. But
you have long nails?
No. I think I felt like I hit something a couple of times, but...
But she is not a virgin?
No. I didn't really hit it with the tip of my fingernail, and I really cut my nails really short.
No. You're not going to do that. But some women, just sexual arousal will cause some bleeding near her period, so it may just be that.
Is there a chance it could be anything else? Because sometimes it happens like right after a period. Sometimes it happens like 2 weeks away. So, I mean...
Some women bleed with sexual arousal.
Well, the blood rushes down there.
Yeah.
And there's this...
The leak.
Like the membrane is thin and stuff.
Springs a leak.
Is that what it is?
Springs a leak.
What does go on down there?
You know, I don't know exactly precisely what the physiology is of what causes bleeding during sexual arousal in some women, but some women just have that, and it's not necessarily abnormal. It's just some instability of the uterine wall, uterine lining.
Yeah, yeah. And that uterine wall, that's something just chicks have, right?
You might have.
Chicks and gay guys or straight guys don't have that?
Not usually. In fact, you can tell the difference between straight guys and
by checking for the uterine wall?
Yeah.
I'm going to go on a little male uterine wall hunt after the show. You with me? You guys going? You need flashlights. That attracts them.
We're back to talking about those headlights again, the glasses. With them.
Oh, right. Jesus. Hey, Clifton?
Yeah, I'm here.
You're 17?
Yes.
You're a virgin, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
You're not even 17, are you?
Huh?
How old are you?
I'm 17.
What year were you born?
84.
All right. Mm-hmm. What's up?
Nothing.
I see.
Nothing. Okay.
Well, the reason we called you is because we have some questions for you. Cypress Hill are big fans of Clifton.
We love Duncan, Arizona.
And we just wanted to check, make sure everything was in order over there.
Oh, it's going all right.
You doing okay, buddy?
A little bit.
All right. Parents riding you? Teachers hassling you? The man on your back?
Most times.
I see.
Any girl problems?
A little bit.
What's the problem?
Well, I'm not circumcised. I don't know if I should show me or not.
In the world, most men are not circumcised.
Who do you want to show your penis to?
My girlfriend.
I see. And is it going to be attached to you when you show it to her, or are you going to send it to her?
Oh, it's
going to
be on me.
Uh-huh. Oh, I'll have to
just say, but Al, here it is. That's interesting. Now. Yeah.
Now, you can do what I did, which is I showed the first girl I showed my penis, I pushed it through the mail slot of the door. That way, I didn't have to be. And I spoke to her through that peephole.
Yeah.
You know, a little hatch.
You thought there was a dog sniffing around or something?
Yeah. I ended up wiping up with the penny saver. It was stuffed in the slot there. Clifton?
Yeah.
Yeah, isn't it amazing I can tell the guys are virgins by their voices? He was 17. Most guys who call this show at 17 are not virgins. I would say 85% of guys who call this show at 17 are not virgins. But as soon as I heard one syllable out of Clifton's young voice, I knew
the
he was a virgin.
The big V popped up?
Yeah, because his voice will change the second he gets laid.
Yeah.
He'll sound like Barry White.
He'll be like, hey, yeah. Adam.
Yeah.
I just, you know.
Hey, you want to smell my finger, buddy?
Look, bro, and if the girl doesn't like you because of that, you got to find a new girlfriend.
All right.
You got to find somebody.
All right.
Simple as
all
that.
Right. All right, Clifton, you're fine there, buddy.
All right.
You wash up nice and good.
Okay.
Yeah. You remember the difference? And I think we all still do it, but we're a little lazier now. We're all big celebrities. We don't have to wash our genitalia quite as much as we used to. But there's two different showers I took when I was young. There was the I'm running late for school or work shower, and then there's someone may be handling my dork shower. The bottle brush came out, the cleanser came out, the loofah. I mean, it was really like washing a van. Big bucket, sponges, and I used to use that glove, that sudsy glove.
Did you have the turtle wax, too?
Yeah, wax it down with a little carnauba, armor all the balls. I mean, it was really a full presentation. I actually detailed my crotch.
Right on.
All right, we'll take ourselves a little break. Cypress Hill is here. When we come back, we'll speak to Tammy. She wants to ask Michelle, who was our earlier caller, to come over and say hi. Come home? What the hell?
Michelle was the...
The hell was that called?
So I think she's one of the... She'd been with a couple of guys and...
Oh, yeah. Is this like her mom?
It was her mom. She was one that would... I recognized the voice from...
Right. No, all right. Mom's on the horn. We'll get to that.
Mom says, get your ass home.
After this.
Love Line. 1-800-LOVE-191. We'll be right back.
Jeff Ernie, Bo Bone Be Real are all here from Cypress Hill.
Right.
Cypress Hill can be found this Friday at the Shrine Auditorium, which if you haven't seen a gig there, is a great old, like, Art Deco 20s. I mean, that place got a lot of history.
This is our first time playing there.
Is it?
Yeah, we're popping our cherry.
It's a good venue, and just to sell it a little more, it's in a place where no matter where you live, it ain't far away. It's kind of right in the middle, right by USC. Cottonmouth King, Soulfly, a bunch of bands are going to be there. And again, what you get with Cypress Hill is you get the bang for your buck.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be a good show. This is the first time for a lot of things. We haven't played the Shrine before. It's our first time playing with Soulfly. And it's going to be good. And this is our first 420 gig, so we're just knocking it all out in one. So,
also, when do you think the new CD is going to come out, by the way?
We're anticipating October.
All
right. You know, right around the time of the smoke out, you know. I mean, it's still tentative, but, you know, definitely sometime around that time.
It'll definitely be this year for sure.
And personally, as a fan, I think, I mean, a lot of fans are waiting for this album. It's going to be great.
All right.
Wow.
So, Jeff Ernie.
Get down.
Wait a minute. What happened to our call?
Oh, my God. Is she gone?
She dropped off. Mama looking for her daughter.
She was on one.
Michelle, go home. Mama said so.
All right.
No, it's not her.
Well, hold on. Who's this?
Hello? Tammy?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
That ain't Tammy.
He said, yeah.
Tammy, it's me.
No.
That ain't true.
It's Tammo.
She dropped off, you goofball.
All right, fine.
All right. Hold on a second, would you?
Hello?
All right. Who do you want to talk to?
Tell Michelle to call Tammy or mom.
Oh, geez, we got to hear
a song.
Geez, I swear to God, you guys, I get a contact high from being around you guys. Have we?
No, we got to hear the song.
We haven't played?
No.
What song are you guys going to play?
I saw this up here and I said, we got to play the song this second.
I know, but are you with the FCC all of a sudden? No, we have to play the song. We must play the song.
You're high. Somebody's got to take command here.
You know, Drew, when you attack my person on the air in front of my legions of fans.
Just stating the fact. You said it yourself.
I am not high. I may have a residual high from other times I've been high. That's possible. I could have belched up a brownie or something.
Flashback.
I can't argue with you on that. But I'm not currently high.
Right.
The world is your oyster.
Jesus Christ.
All the world is. You want me to start doing heroin? I swear to Christ, I never said that. That's Gilbert Godfrey in here screwing with me. All right, let's hear something else from Cypress Hill. This is called You Can't Get the Best of Me.
I've been rocking for years, now it's time to go to lane. Bucking MCs and they tracks, I stop them. My rap style, make a ton dropper. My concepts, I'm sick like Dennis Hopper. I jack boom fuckers, stick them like dirty coppers. Like I said before, I'm taking you label whores. Down to the bone, y'all can dance on your go for. Only one way to deal with these softies. Take the ass out, let me roll, get Ray Fossey. And when you test me, you better freestyle. Cause my can go on and on and on for miles. You can't get the best of me. Can't get the best of me. You can't get the best of me. Hold me down. Can't get the
check it out, you know. So if it comes down to who's the locust bato, I'm down for the clown and slanging them putazos. Payaso, don't get too close, I break brazos. Gonna make a move and smoke your asho. Remove that sucker and the whack ass. Cause every time I see he's acting like a bitch. So let's get it straight, I smoke the competition. Breaking down dudes in my mother's mission. One by one, they'll all come up missing. You can't fuck with this kid, I ain't bitching.
Why we love Cypress Hill. You guys missed it. We had 10 minutes of Drew arguing with Cypress Hill about why weed should be illegal. No. It was funny.
Well, actually, this was the first time he was on our side about it.
Well, no, I've always said I haven't come down squarely yet, and now I'm down.
Come around. He's come around.
Let me tell you something. He uses Cypress Hill as an argument of weed legalization. You see, he always tells me, those guys are basically mellow criminals now. They're too lazy to rip you off now. That's why the weed is good. Speed. They'd be kicking our ass out in the parking lot right now, right?
You know, alcohol.
True, you get rolled before you got out to your BMW.
You know what's funny is that the Deftones were on here not too long ago, and you guys were talking about that. and Stefan, you know, we
brought up Cypress Hill,
yeah,
right?
We got a band together, and he was telling me, yeah, he brought you guys up in a weed discussion.
That's right.
That's like asking B-Real and Bobo to stop smoking weed tomorrow or something like that.
Drew uses Cypress Hill as an example.
But that's all right. That just means we left an impression on the doctor.
It's always done out of love.
Tammy,
yeah. Now yeah. You called, you fell off the line, but you're back, right?
I know, I'm back.
And was it Michelle? Was that your daughter?
The Michelle girl sounded just like my daughter. I think that's her.
And where?
I know she's pregnant. My daughter is pregnant, and she's been missing for about a month. Mm. And I just kind of wanted to get a message to her, you know, at least just call home and, you know, do the right thing for the baby. And y'all told her to go to family planning, and that was a good thing. But, God, just call home.
How old is your daughter?
21.
Mm-hmm.
How long has she been gone for a month?
Yes.
Have you not heard from her in a month?
Right. And you know what? I don't know. I think the Michelle girl that you talked to,
yeah.
I don't know what age she is.
I think she said 17.
She was listening to music, and I was flipping through stations, and I heard her voice.
That's a pretty unremarkable.
And I came back, because it was my daughter's voice.
It's a pretty remarkable, I mean, unmistakable voice. I recognize it from her having called.
A mother should recognize her daughter's voice.
Was she saying it was the girl that had sex with the two guys?
Yeah.
Is that who you're talking about?
Or is it the one who's pregnant?
I didn't hear that part. And actually, if I was her mother and if it is my daughter, I don't want to hear the part that she had sex with two guys.
Of course.
All I'm saying is she said she was 17. So,
yeah.
She's pregnant. Oh, is this girl 17?
Well, yeah. One of them was. Well,
One was 21.
The Michelle girl, the one whose name was Michelle.
All right. So if it's your daughter or not, is your daughter, you're calling from Texas?
Yes.
Is your daughter in Texas, or do you have any idea?
No. She was in Massachusetts. She was in New York. She was in Pennsylvania. She's doing the internet hopping thing.
Wow.
And I think she's in Kentucky now. But see, I only got in on the last part of it. And the girl I talked to on the phone, you know, when I called y'all, I don't know if this is my daughter. But she sounded like my daughter.
Okay. Wait a second. How come your daughter's not calling you, though?
I don't know. I'm raising her first kid.
That might be her then.
There was another one. Yeah.
Right. All right.
I'm raising her first child.
Oh, baby. All right. Well, listen.
No, you know what? Even if it's not my daughter, if y'all could just tell Michelle, you know what? Just get in touch with your family and let them know that you're okay. Because I don't think, whether it's my daughter or not,
It's somebody's daughter.
It's somebody's daughter.
You know, call your mom and just let them know you're okay.
Even if it's not your mom, a family member.
Yeah.
We don't hate you. We don't hate you for what you're doing. We just want to know that you're still alive and you're still breathing and you're not dead in a ditch somewhere.
All right there, baby.
But you know what?
Yeah.
Michelle sounded just like my daughter.
All right. Well, listen, I'll tell you what. If Michelle was your daughter and she's listening, call your mom in Texas. And if it's not you, but someone knows who we're talking about, someone's listening to the show, have her call. And listen, you don't have to make any promises. You don't have to come home. Just call and say you're alive.
Yep. Just say, I'm still breathing.
Yeah, yep.
And that's all you got to say.
All right, Tammy.
Good luck,
Tammy. Take care of yourself.
That's a good message. And you know what? I was just flipping through stations, and I found y'all. I heard that voice, and I had a call. But, you know, and I've kind of heard a little bit about what y'all do, and the family planning thing is good. But, you know, just kind of get a message to the people out there, to the kids out there who don't get in touch with their parents. Because believe me, we go crazy. That's what makes our hair turn gray and white.
All right.
Because our kids get crazy, and they decide that we don't give a shit.
Easy with the S.
Tammy, thanks for the call, really.
All right, we'll take a break, and we'll be back.
Hello, who's this?
This is LoveLine.
1-800-LOVE-191. LoveLine will be right back.
There you go. 2 hours gone in the blink
in
of an eye.
Just like vegetables.
That's right.
With you guys around.
Gone, then a B-load out of B-Reels bong. Wow, that's a lot of alliteration. I want to thank Cypress Hill for coming in here. I always enjoy these guys.
We want to thank you for, like, not being mad at us for being late.
Say, man, we're speeding, man. They're going to be mad.
I'd say this is probably the only guys that can get away with being late. We wouldn't even think about
Don't care.
Yeah.
Glad to have you for any length of time. So, again, everybody, go out this Friday. Go out to the Shrine. See Cypress Hill. See Soulfly. See Cottonmouth Kings. See other excellent bands. And this Saturday, 7 o'clock?
Yeah, I believe so. No, Friday.
Oh, I'm sorry. Friday.
See, he's already contacted.
7 o'clock, everybody.
And I just want to remind people about the Key Club on Sunday nights, the Battle of the Bands. And come out, support the local bands, and be a part of the process. And I want to say what's up to my son Chris out there. What's up?
Anybody who likes this show, you better like Cypress Hill.
You better like it, man.
And until next time, this is Adam Kroll for Dr. Drew saying, mahalo.
Mahalo, bro.
Be clean. I mean, come clean. I mean...
This has been LoveLine. The opinions expressed on the show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for LoveLine is Ann Wilkins Engel. LoveLine is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.